Hi Taurus, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to your October read. Taurus, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's see, Taurus, what energies are flowing towards you in October now. My angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Taurus and send them the messages they need to hear the most for the month of October. Thank you. All right, here we go. Taurus for October, welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here again. And if you're new here, Taurus, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. Taurus, Queen of Cups coming up in October. Lot of self-care. Seeing your worth, very intuitive. Okay, balance is returning, Taurus. Thank God. Temperance is here for you in October, Taurus. At the current moment, I feel that you are still a bit undecided. You could be listening to this reading and saying, what do you mean self-care? I don't even know which direction I'm going, right? I'm stuck here in no man's land and kind of wondering now where's my life going? But don't worry about it, because the October card for you is Temperance and the Queen of Cups. All right, let's see what this is all about. First, I'm going to take Taurus, a Ganesha oracle card for you. Let's see what Lord Ganesha has for my Taurus gang for the month of October. For Taurus, Lord Ganesha, a blessing, please, a message, some guidance. Splendor, beautiful. That looks like the Queen of Cups, right? This is again, you know, surrounding yourself with nice things, so you feel special because you are special and attracting the same. I'm going to take a few lines out of the book, Taurus, because I'm sure there's a very special message in this for you. Page 46. Okay, here we go. Seek and honor the beauty and splendor that is within you and around you, Queen of Cups. Ganesha is surrounded by beauty in this card and is calling it to your attention. Awaken to what you are surrounding yourself with at this moment. See more deeply and be aware of the impact of your surroundings on what you create in your life. Ganesha urges you to let beauty penetrate into your heart. You will naturally respond to this beauty by fostering more care and love, not only in your life, but also in the lives of those around you. If your critical voice has been overactive lately, or you find that you've been dwelling on negative behaviors, take a moment to realign yourself. You arrived in this world as a unique, magnificent individual. The core of your being is whole, beautiful and filled with love. The essence of your higher self wants nothing more or less than for you to be who you were created to be. Ganesha is standing in the meadow surrounded by flowers. The flowers symbolize perfection and beauty. The variety of colors streams healing, loving energy in your direction. The butterflies symbolize the change and evolution that your soul is undertaking. Remember to have an awareness of your surroundings. See the splendor that is being shown to you and utilize this energy to support your own transformation. Let me show you the card first before I move on. Look at this. Internalize this card. This is what you're supposed to do. Take care of yourself and surround yourself with love around you and within you. And yeah, whatever you are confused about, if something is not making you feel good, Taurus, go the other path. Okay, let's start your reading. Why is my Taurus gang in the Two of Wands currently, Spirit? This is current, the before October, right? This is when I'm doing the reading. Two of Wands. And yeah, I mean, October starts tomorrow, but this is what you've been in for the last few days, I would feel. Yes, you're wondering which side to drop, right? You are pulled between two different directions and you're wondering, now I have to drop something, which one should I drop? So what else for the current energy spirit? There's a choice to be made, Taurus. There's a choice. What a clear reading. Here you are standing between two, having to make this decision, having to make a choice as to which one to drop. So this could be anything for you, Taurus. This could be two relationships. This could be deciding between moving to two different cities, could be two different jobs, could be anything, you know, wondering which flavor of ice cream to eat. I mean, I'm just kidding, but you know, this is a big, big life decision. So what happened in the recent past, Spirit, with the Six of Cups? Six of Cups. I think for a very, very long time, Taurus, you've been wanting to bring back some happiness, some youthful energy, that newness in your life, get over some kind of heartbreak about something which has hurt you tremendously. Maybe there's been a lot of conflict which you've been wanting to drop, right? Because this could again be in your office environment, could be at home, could be anywhere, but you've been wanting to drop something which has been very conflicting to you for a very long time and heal this broken heart of yours. And I think you're getting there because this is your wish. I want to experience happiness once again. And right now, yes, you could be, you know, still kind of choosing which one to drop, what to do, what decision to make. So let's see what's happening in October then. So Spirit, Queen of Cups, what's coming up for Taurus in October? Queen of Cups. You will make that decision. Isn't that fabulous? Here you are standing here wondering which decision to make, and in October you will make that final decision. And it'll be something that's going to make you feel very good, Taurus, because you're showing up as the Queen of Cups upright. Heart will be full of love and happiness. Let's see what this is. I need some more clarification, Spirit, for Taurus for October. What can we expect? Yes, you're coming out of feeling lack, you're coming out of any, you see this, you're coming out. This is like a person who's stuck feeling lost and lonely and in lack, but you'll be coming out of that now. Coming out of any place or person or circumstance that feels deceptive to you. So you will be making a very, very wise decision. And then what, Spirit? Yes, you're ready now, you're ready. You've been battered and bruised a lot, I feel, and it's left you maybe feeling very upset and angry. But you know, Taurus, if you take this advice that Lord Ganesha is giving you and fill your heart with that innocence and happiness and joy, I'm sure that you will be ready to fight one more day. It doesn't matter, you have been hurt, but now you're bandaged, right? And you're going to be feeling that, hey, I'm still lovable. I still, you know, I want to fight for life one more time. What else, Spirit, for Taurus in October? Yes, you're coming out of this feeling of sadness, feeling of neglect, feeling bored, feeling rejected. All that is in the reverse for you, Taurus, in because of the own decision, this decision that you will be making. Whatever two directions you're faced with currently, you will be making the correct decision to be able to get out of this funk that you find yourself in. So what should Taurus hold on to? Taurus, I just explained this card to you, right? The Nine of Wands. Hold on to that last wand of yours. At least that's how you feel. I only have one chance left. But no, chances keep coming, don't worry about that. But right now, currently, you may be feeling, you know, I've been battered so many times, but I just have that one left. Spirit is saying, hold on to it tight. Hold on to it tight, because this one is really going to take you places. I mean, your maybe karmic cycle with whatever you've been dealing with is practically over, but we need you to stand strong and not back down. So why should Taurus hold on to the Nine of Wands, Spirit? because now you're becoming a magician. You are being gifted in October all the elements possible from the universe to magically transform your life. You're going to be the magician of your own life, Taurus, in October. Don't waste this opportunity. You have the wand and the pentacle and the cup and what else is there? The sword. All the four elements of the universe will be gifted to you. And it's up to you, Spirit is saying. Make that choice, make that decision, and fight for what you want to create, and it'll happen. Go into self-care and self-love. See what makes you feel happy. One more, Spirit, for the Nine of Wands. Yeah, Spirit is saying now is not the time to hold back. Now is not the time to hold back. It's time, in fact, to... Yes, you've been hurt. People have breadcrumbed you probably, or you haven't got what you deserved in the past. But it's the ending of that. The only person who can hold back from manifesting a new life for you, Taurus, in October is you. So make sure you don't do that. Okay? So let's see what should Taurus let go of then. The Chariot. Why should Taurus let go of that, Spirit? Ah, okay. Taurus, if there's any naysayers around you who, you know, want to stop your progress here, there is progress coming. The Chariot is here, and you may be wishing to start concentrating more on yourself, maybe your own pentacle, maybe your own life. And if there's somebody around here who wants to stall or stop this progress, don't overthink it. Don't overthink it. This is only in your mind that you're trapped. This is the blindfold you have on your eyes where you feel you're trapped, but you're actually not. And this is the only thing that's going to stall you from having this forward movement. Maybe your anger, your resentment, or just feeling that I'm trapped. So this card came out in reverse. This is going to be a month to remove that blindfold from your eyes. Fight for what you want. The path in front of this person is absolutely open, Taurus, if you can see this card properly. The swords are only all around. I mean, on the sides and at the back. The path in front of this person is completely been cleared out. The only thing stopping this person in the card from not moving is the blindfold on their eyes. This has to be dropped. Okay? So otherwise then it becomes a blockage, because this is self-sabotage. Feeling you can't do something. Feeling you can't move forward. Feeling you can't take care of yourself. Why? Because there's somebody around you, maybe. Maybe your boss, maybe your spouse, maybe your brother, maybe a friend, whoever. They want to convince you that you can't. All right, so what can become a blockage, Spirit, for Taurus to move forward? The Hermit. Too much of overthinking, I would feel. Isolating yourself, feeling that you're not lovable. Maybe somebody has been kind of telling you that, or making you feel less than, or depleting your energy. Spirit is saying it's time to kind of take care of yourself. Spend some time alone. You should, because that replenishes your cup. Even if people around you are not filling your cup back and they're draining you out, isolate yourself. Isolate yourself for a little while. Your answers will come. Look at this rebirth coming for you. Wow. The angels are blowing their trumpet for you, Taurus. You will be guided so beautifully, but it's up to you now to make that choice. Where are you going to feel this way, or what the energies are flowing towards you? This is guaranteed for you, but then you have a choice to take it, right? Are you going to sit here feeling depleted and feeling not worth it or unloved or whatever? Emotionally very, very overwhelmed. If somebody around you is doing that to you, Taurus, isolate yourself for a little while if possible, because this is possible for you. Don't let this become a blockage. All right, so now let's see. How will people be viewing my Taurus in October? Queen of Wands. See, that's my Taurus. Okay, so people have to see you like this, Taurus. Don't sit in this energy for too long, please. This is a choice you have. Some of you will take it, some won't. But if you are here, you know, in the Omkara family, I would really recommend that you take this advice, because this is how I want to see you. Looking good, feeling good, ready to take on the world, turning heads. Wow. Queen of Wands, Spirit. Queen of Wands. Yes, there will be a lot of drama around you. There will be a lot of, please, I'm warning you, there will be people trying to create rifts and drama and anger and fights and whatever. But you know what, Taurus? What they're going to realize, hey, somebody is very peaceful. They've retreated. And not just retreated, they've refilled that cup of theirs and they are on their way. Nothing can disturb this Queen of Wands peace now, because they've taken time out. They've taken time out to reflect, to connect and fill their own cup. Taurus, bravo, way to go. I want my Taurus gang to be in this energy in the month of October. If you're still doubting yourself, if you're still allowing other people to deplete you, please don't do that. You owe it to yourself. Like Lord Ganesha said, you weren't born for having misery or bad luck or live in feelings of desperation or anything like that. We were all born to experience joy in our life. You owe it to yourself. All right, so Spirit, what's your secret message to my Taurus gang? Empress. I love this reading for you, Taurus, after a very long time. I know some of you have been going through a lot. But this is Spirit's secret message for you. It's knocking on my brain that I need to say right now, Taurus, is what Spirit is saying. Yes, we've put you through a lot of trials, lot of tribulations. We've given you so much, so many battles to fight. But all that has only strengthened you. It's like to become the empress or the emperor, you have to go through everything. You have to be each king and each queen to actually reach the status of being the emperor or the empress. So now this is your time. So Empress, Spirit, why is the empress here? As Taurus is... And this is not a gender bias card, please, my male, masculine Taurians out there. I know a lot of... mixed gender is now on my channel, which is really exciting. I'm so happy that, especially with the love reads, when I'm doing person A and person B, very unbiased about the two energies, I have a lot of masculine energies who are now part of my channel, and I'm so happy that I'm able to relate to all of you on a very unbiased way. So like I'm saying, Empress basically means having fertility, growth and abundance. So this is what is promised. Let's see. Taurus, Chariot. You're on your way. You're on your way. This is what is promised to you, Taurus. Focused, moving forward, sitting on your throne, moving towards fertility, growth, and abundance. Yes, maybe you'll have to disrupt a few things, but whatever has not been working out for you, whatever has to be let go of, you will be, maybe taking a stance to do all that. But guess what? The minute you go take that or make that choice, Ace of Pentacles. This is a brand new cycle starting in your life, Taurus. It's starting from the Ace. And bringing in harmony, balance back to your life. Okay? So now that you've seen this reading, Taurus, I need you to love yourself like you were the most special person in the life, in this world, for you. Give yourself that pedestal from this second onwards. Okay? And yes, that's all I have for you, Taurus. I'll see you soon. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.